would end up losing the forward pressure on the tongues of my boots. And I did this drill almost every morning before training just to make sure I was moving my hips forward and not up, so I could actually start the turn on the shovel of my ski with my ankles and knees. When you're passing a pole behind your back, common mistake is to pass a pole to the wrong arm. So you're trying to pass the pole from your inside arm through transition behind your back to your new upcoming inside arm. And then as you grab the pole with your new inside arm, you start to level and you start to bring your outside down. So it's almost like when I used to do this drill, the second I grabbed the pole, I would be really patient bringing it forward, and then I'd try to keep it as level as possible with the snow and just bring my outside down. So it's not moving the pole around really abruptly. You're always being really smooth, really patient with it. And then that makes it more of a flow when you're skiing. And this drill also really helps with an athletic stance. When you're passing it behind your back, you want to be moving forward, like I said, and you want to be square with your shoulders, hips, knees. Everything should be square with where your skis are pointed. And then as you move into the turn, you get that pole moving forward to your new inside arm, you can start to level out into parallel position.